The NBA on 2K Sports with Greg Anthony and Hall of Famer Doris Burke. This is Kevin Harlan. And joining us on the sidelines, another Hall of Famer, David Aldridge. Hey, Dave.
Thanks very much. Now, Commissioner Adam Silver is continuing to push for the creation of an in-season tournament. He says the notion is to steal a page from European soccer. It's not the Larry O'Brien trophy, but something secondary that teams care about. Something you'd see players go into that extra gear for. Kevin, back to you.
That's pretty intriguing, DA. That's an interesting story, and we thank you for giving it to us. So here is Miami's starting group. They've got Miller, and it's Walker in at the center position. And for Houston, at this point of the season, Greg, right in the heart of the schedule, what are the biggest challenges for a player?
Kevin, sometimes it's just about knowing what city you're in. The travel in this league is crazy, but you really want to keep focus and sleep and eat right. Vital.
Tip off goes to Houston. Five to shoot. From the arc. Miller grabs the miss, and so Miller will bring it up for Miami. Out to the wing, to the middle. Off to a good start as he hits his first shot attempt.
Always feels good getting that first one in the bank.
And will that get him rolling? Will it get his team rolling? This should be an interesting night.
Shot's good by Walker.
And he's not going to miss that sort of an opportunity from deep.
And so here is Houston. First quarter of play, 1 minute played. Here's Roberts. Goes back up. And the layup is up and in.
Just setting the tone with an aggressive move to the rack. And where's the help defensively?
To me, that's a complete lack of communication on that side of the ball. These guys need to be talking to each other.
Shoots. That shot, no good. And Houston the other way now.
Yeah, it was all hands on deck. Helps to get points off the bench when you're on the road.
One thing we know, great teams in the NBA get production off the bench, and that was critical that night.
Now, here is Miller. 8 points his last outing. Here's Walker. His second shot goes in, off to a good start, 2 for 2.
Well, this is the kind of pass that gets everyone excited. It's also how you build great team chemistry.
For Houston, they've gone 2 of 5 here, making 40% so far to start out the game. Pass to Roberts. And about 2 minutes played here in the first quarter. Shot clock at 6. Rejected by Walker. Pass to Wall. Here's Pat. There's the triple. And that one goes out of bounds. Last touch by Walker. So a moment now to see the story for him.
And guys, I think the best way to measure his performance these last 10 games is his effective field goal percentage, which has improved, a sign that his game is in much better shape than it was not too long ago.
Good ball movement here by Miami. Left side, Walker, just 5 on the clock. For the 3, the shot, no good. So Houston will take it the other way.
And sometimes it's a lot harder to get easy looks on the road, but they found ways to get their guys good looks.
Well, they knew exactly how to approach that defense. They shot a fantastic percentage because they got quality looks.
Houston shooting their first free throws here tonight.
And they've had really good numbers all season from the free throw line.
That free throw missing. He hits the second from the line. We're about 3 minutes into this first quarter. With the teardrop. Second chance shot. Out of bounds. Houston takes possession. Almost halfway through the season, let's check out the standings out west. You look at Houston, season well underway, and they've been solid in third right now.
And you know, Houston, they had a few critics coming into the season, and now I don't think they have any. This is a club ready to not only make a deep run, but possibly win it all.
Well, this is their goal. There's no doubt about that. For what many expected of them so far, they have not disappointed.
Off target with the open look. For Miami, they've gone just 2 of 7 so far. A little bit of a slow start for them. There's the pass to Wall. Let's it go from 14. That's good on the jump shot.
They seem to concede that shot, and his response is, thank you very much.
Pass to Roberts. Walker is screened on Miller. Here's Mark. Miller grabs the miss.
Boy, that's the kind of look this offense is designed to create. That's just a tough miss.
Stolen by Walker. Here we go, one-on-one. Here's Mark. Plays it up and banks it in. 5 points in the game.
And you can see the importance of that steal. Really a four-point swing with the conversion at the other end.
For Miami, they've gotten 3 of 8 shots to fall for them here in the first quarter. Long passes to Pat. Three-pointer. First shot, first basket. He's out of the blocks fast.
And the lack of effort to fight over the screen there makes that an easy shot.
You know, we see this all the time. You're basically, as a defender, hoping the man misses rather than putting in the work to get over screens.
Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot 2 free throws. Houston shooting their 3rd and 4th free throw shots of the night. First one falls for him. And a new group getting ready for Miami. He hits both from the stripe.
An efficient night from the line. This is a guy who puts in the work and it pays dividends.
Pass to Joseph. And he banks in the layup.
This is what we call highly efficient play. Working off the screen, getting to the cup.
Sasser. He's covered by Joseph. Outside Wilson. There's a good screen. The feed to Walker. No good on that one. And it's Watson with the ball for Miami. It's a 3-point game.
Actually, I thought they might be able to sustain that momentum that they picked up in the fourth quarter, but was not meant to be.
Here's Joseph. That's his second shot and his second basket. He's 2 for 2. And now another look at that great drive and finish brought to you by Mobile One.
It's all about the ability to get 2 feet in the paint, whether it's creating for a teammate or for yourself.
Passes it to Wilson.
Oh,
Here's Sasser. Miami grabs the miss. Watson surveying the D. The pass to Joseph. Now Watson. And here's Joseph for three. It doesn't go for him. And Houston the other way now. Pass to Wilson. Over to the left wing. Shot clock at five. Houston needs to get a shot off. And it's Joseph in the corner. And Watson has it in the corner. Six to shoot. Miami no good on that time either. Houston trails by five. There's 53 seconds left to play in the first. Inside to end the drought. He doesn't hit that one. And Miami the other way now. They play the clock right, then go two for one.
Just got to time it up right.
Lets it go from deep. The offensive rebound. Walker on the follow.
And folks, he did not luck into that one. He knew just where he wanted to be to grab that backboard.
24 seconds left in the first quarter. To the inside. Out to the right wing. The three. And another shot. It's hauled in by Watson.
Boy, nine times out of ten, that's going in. I'm sure he surprised himself with the miss.
The three from Joseph. And so it's Miami, bringing the quarter to a close with a seven-point lead. And it's been their rugged defense setting the tone. And we'll be back with you shortly. And for those of you just tuning in, the second quarter of action is where we're at right now. And let's quickly break down the game we've seen from Miami, guys.
You got to credit their defense, communicating, rotating, making plays on the ball.
Yeah, I think they wanted to come out of the gate strong, and they have. They've taken the early lead here.
Miami leading by seven. On the floor for Miami. Here's Pat. His last outing, 16 points for him. Count that bucket. Pat's got five.
And there's a pattern starting to take shape here. They're working it inside and getting good shots from close range.
Three-pointer. He's now one for two with that bucket.
What a terrific play by just a tremendous all-around player. This guy makes it look easy.
And Miami shooting 47% from the floor, getting it done. Pass to Long. 13 feet away. Rebound by Roberts. Out of bounds. Miami takes possession. The league's long-distance bombers are setting their sights on the three-point contest this season. Here are some of the early favorites to make up the field.
And I love the way the voting is shaping up, Kevin. We'll have an excellent contest if these are the shooters who are firing away on All-Star Weekend.
There are a few players ahead of him in the voting, but if he holds on to his spot at number five on that list, he'll have a place in the three-point contest waiting for him.
And if anything, I bet he moves up the list. I mean, how could you not have this fella taking part in this contest? He'll be there.
And as the votes keep pouring in, we'll keep you updated on any changes to that list. It looks like we're going to have quite a group.
Man, you talk about the ultimate marksman's list here, Kevin. Maybe this will be the year somebody gets that perfect score.
Miami leading by six. evaluating recent attempts, Doris, to create super teams. They haven't quite worked out as planned, have they?
What we understand now is the game isn't played on paper. So many things go into winning. Chemistry, health, and if you risk your future trying to put together a super team with no consideration for what comes next, that can be problematic.
Here's Mark with the drive out to the right wing. They shoot again. That one off the back iron and out.
Listen, he can make that shot right there, but I do know they have other options they can go to.
Pack passes to Miller. Here's Pack. Back to Miller. Six on the shot clock. Here's Wong. Out of bounds. Houston takes possession. And why don't we take a chance now to see which teams have been the NBA's highest scoring squads this month.
I just love their offensive flow lately. I mean, this is a dominant team offensively because of that rhythm and pace.
Second quarter of play with almost 3 minutes gone. And the basket is good. Now just a four-point Miami lead. For Miami, they've gone 2 of 5 from the field here in the second quarter, shooting 40%. Miller, the pass to Wong. To the middle. Casey. Rebound by Roberts. Roberts got his fourth rebound in this one. Good D by Miller. And here's Miller. He'll bring it up for Miami. Their biggest lead of the game was 9. That is game 3 of this 4-game trip. Passes it to Wall. Knocks down the 3-ball. 8 points for him.
Well, after hitting 0 from distance in the first, that's his second make this quarter.
The pass to Roberts. Just under 3.5 minutes played here in the second quarter. It's good.
Yeah, and there it is again. On a lot of their possessions this first half, they've established great inside position.
Miami leading by 5. Here's Wong. No good from outside.
Well, it hasn't been the most efficient game for this guy, but their team is fortunate to still be out in front.
Here's Mark. Miami grabs the miss.
And he's a good shooter from outside, but not sure from that deep.
Boy, we're seeing it more and more. Guys looking to create additional space by stepping back further from the line.
Casey, that one's in. His first bucket of the game. He's 1 for 2.
And that's right where they wanted to go with the ball, in rhythm.
And it's Roberts, top of the key. They get a hand on it. Clock at 6. Here's the 3. No good that time. And it's Miami the other way. Pass to Wall. Here's Pat. They set the screen. Out of bounds. Houston takes possession.
And a moment now to see some numbers for Roberts. And with a top 20 ranking in field goal percentage, you put the ball in his hands, and he converts at a remarkable rate.
And as you were saying, one of the better rebounders in the league, he just has that tireless work ethic that also motivates the rest of his teammates. And Houston calls their first timeout of the game. Houston trails by 7. Sasser, he's covered by Joseph. Takes the 3. Miami grabs the miss.
And battling hard on the glass, they hold the advantage here so far.
Releases. Shot is good off the back rim and in. And now it's a 9-point Miami lead. Here's Sasser driving inside. And he drops in the layup off the glass.
Well, you get exactly what you want right there. Clean look right at the cup. Nicely done.
Miami with the ball. Outside, Joseph. The shot missing. So Houston will take it the other way. They're off to San Antonio after this game, bringing their show to the AT&T Center. That will be a getaway game for them, a one-game road trip. Down low. Walker in the post. Joseph on him. Yep, it goes in, and the Miami lead is cut down now to just 5 on the bucket from Walker. And so it's Joseph with it. He'll bring it up for Miami. Pass to Watson. Trying his luck from deep. That shot misses. For Houston, they've gone 6-12 in the second quarter, right at the 50% mark from the field. Kicks it out to Wilson. Passes it to Walker. Pulls up, high post, and it's Miami with the rebound. Miller's got 4 rebounds in this game. There's the pass to Joseph, and it's Houston on the break. Here's Sasser. Finds the hole for the second time from the floor, now 2 for 5. There's 57 seconds left in the first half of the game. Right side, Joseph. Now let's take a second to bring up our rookie leaderboard for a glance at this year's top first-year free throw shooters. This is his first free throw of the game. And the first one drops. Good on both. There's 48 seconds left to play here in the second quarter. Outside, Walker. Here's Sasser. And it goes down 2 points. He's got 8.
Man, have they been effective at getting the ball inside.
...35 seconds left in the first half. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot 2 at the free throw line.
Yeah, easy call.
For Miami, they have been perfect at the line so far, albeit just 2 for 2. First free throw is good. And good on the second, so he makes them both.
and they're really getting more points at the free throw line here in the second quarter.
Outside, Walker. Sasser, he's covered by Joseph. A three ball. Walker with the rebound. Beyond the arc. He can't get that one. And a close game so far through the first two quarters as we reach halftime. Miami ahead. They're up by five. We'll get right back to the action when we return.
Hey there, everybody. With the All-Star break on the horizon, let's first have a look at the players vying for a spot in the three-point contest. All right, so the three-point contest is a great part of All-Star Weekend. But let me ask you guys, what contest would you add?
A cooking competition.
Oh, here we go.
Yeah, sample some fresh barbecue chicken.
And now we look back at the first half. Guys, some adjustments needed for Houston.
Hate to say it, the three ball just isn't doing it for them. They have to try something different. More movement, screens, drive to the bucket, layups, points in the paint, something.
Yeah, a lot of that. I mean, I agree with all that. Maybe be more disciplined when it comes to shot selection, and maybe I should be more disciplined and not interrupting you.
That too.
And that is a wrap. Now let's send you back to Kevin Harlan for the start of the third quarter.
And as we get into this third quarter, as we've seen so far, neither team able to create much separation on the scoreboard yet. And so here is Miami. Here's Wong, and the layup falls. 10 points for him.
Terrific play call to give him a clean look at the rim. That's how you want to start the second half.
Well, there is nothing better than catching a rhythm as early as possible, and boy, that's a terrific start right there.
And for Miami, they've got Pat, and it's Miller in at the small forward position. Sasser played in with a nice touch off the glass.
That's the 10th straight point they've given up in the paint.
Miami leading by five. And two free throws coming up, unable to get that one to go with all the contact. For Miami, they have been solid at the line so far, 4 for 4. First free throw is good. And that's good as he hits both of his shots. Houston trails by 7. Kicks it to Walker. Second half rolling along now. About a minute played here. Rejected by Walker. Down to 5 on the shot clock. They set the pick. Fires the 3. It's not going to go for him. And it's Miami the other way.
And that's the battle. They haven't been winning today. Their work on the glass has been porous, and that's got to change.
And no surprise here, right? This guy is not only a gifted player, but he is so smart on the offensive end.
For Houston, they've gone 1 of 3 since starting the second half. Guys, they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time taking the lid off.
Pass to Walker. Walker with the rebound. Walker's got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. The jump hook. That one wide left. Houston trails by 9. Pass to Roberts. And it's Miami with the rebound. Walker's got rebound number 5 here tonight. Second half of play with just under 2.5 minutes gone. Passes to Pat. Dishes it to Walker. Good ball movement here by Miami. For the 3. It's rebounded by Houston.
He is single-handedly dropping the temperature in here with that cold streak.
He is trying to shoot his way out of it, and it might be better for him to pass the basketball at this point.
And even with good coverage defensively that time, he has confidence to drill the 3.
Here's Wong. And he can't extend the lead to double digits. And so it's Roberts. He'll bring up the ball for Houston. Their defense has only allowed 6 points in the second half. They need this one. Pat grabs the board.
This has not been a good period for this guy. Out of sync, not letting the game come to him. He's got to settle down and make shots. Boy, he can't buy a bucket. Shut out completely so far, and yet they're still ahead.
Mark, covered by Miller. The pass to Roberts. Buries it down low. Roberts got his second basket of the game. Miami leading by 7. The kick out to Walker. Miami no good on that time either. For Houston, they've gone just 25% from the field here in the second half. They're 2 of 8. Mark, covered by Miller. Here's Mark. The shot comes out, and Miami the other way now. Pass to Wong. Here's Pat. Miller outside. Pass to Pat. The tray. Walker with the rebound. Houston trails by 7. Sasser guarded by Walker. Here's Roberts. He provides a good amount of offense for the team, averaging around 11.5 points a game.
Well, we've seen that movie a few times, haven't we? An easy bucket in the paint.
And Miami calls their first timeout of the game. Both teams deciding to change it up. Here is a list of the NBA's most adept passing teams this season. These are your assist leaders.
And you know, when your team has a lot of assists, it's testimony to the unselfishness, the patience, the ball movement, the player movement. They have shown all of that.
Miami leading by five. Passes it to Watson. Outside, Joseph. Launches a three. Miami no good on that time either.
He is just not taking smart shots out there, a pattern he has fallen into tonight.
Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul. For Houston, they have been successful on three of their four free throw attempts up to this point. And the first one at the line is good. That one falls, so he hits both of them. Here's Joseph. He's got eight. They swipe it. Here's Roberts. He's covered by Joseph. Another miss by Houston.
Well, the defense clearly was not interested in guarding him from downtown. They're very fortunate he missed.
Kicks to Watson, trying to end the drought. Rebound by Roberts. Roberts got rebound number eight now on the night. And there's the pass to Wilson. And some nice passing there by Houston. That one falls. Roberts got his third basket of the night right there.
Sees his man has the angle on the interior and drops a dime right there.
We've got 1:55 left to play here in the third. Outside, Joseph. Taken away. And they're moving it up for the lead. Wilson kicks to Roberts. Second shot opportunity. And it's Miami with the rebound. Now Joseph. And looking at his production, he averages a little more than 7 points a game. Pass to Watson. Six on the shot clock. Puts it up. Rebound by Roberts. Roberts got nine rebounds in the game. Getting it done. Outside Wilson. 16 feet away. And he recovers it. The shot, no good. And so it's Watson who will bring it up for Miami. They lead by one to the wing right side. And here's Joseph for three. It's rebounded by Houston. Roberts got double-digit rebounds now in the game. To the wing on the left. 24 seconds left to play in the third. For the lead. That one doesn't drop.
Well, certainly not the best defensive effort, but this guy can't make them pay for their laziness.
And here's Joseph for three. No good on that one. Fires the three, and he was able to put it up in time, but doesn't fall. And we just finished the third quarter, and we've got a tight ball game here. Miami leads by just one. And we'll have the start of the fourth quarter for you as soon as we get back from this short break. Well, this has been a great contest so far, and I imagine the fourth quarter could have even more action in store for us. And so here is Houston. They trail by one. To take the lead. The putback controls the rebound and puts it back up and in. And Houston leads by one.
And that bucket adds to what has been a big difference in points in the paint between the two teams.
And for Miami. Passes it to Wong. Miller outside. From the line. No good off the back of the rim. And for Houston, they're shooting just 31% in the game. About a minute played here in the fourth quarter. Driving in, and he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line. And let's take a moment, guys, to get your take on the scoring so far for Houston.
They're still slashing and attacking the rim, and the defense yet to make the adjustment and keep the ball in front.
They've also made a concerted effort to get the ball down low. Many of their points coming in that painted area tonight.
First free throw is good. Houston making a switch here. And he makes both free throws.
Impeccable from the line since halftime.
Miami trails by three. Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, a cold stretch offensively for sure.
There's the drive. Kept alive. Here's Wong. No good with the layup. And here's Houston. Here in the fourth quarter, their defense has been very strong, allowing no baskets. Launches it, six to shoot, connects from three-point range.
Well, if you offer no resistance defensively, he's going to knock down the three. It's really that simple, guys.
To end the run, doesn't go for him. And Houston the other way now. Second minute off the clock now in the fourth. Sasser and a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot two here.
And you know what? You allow a guy to get right to the rim like that, that's your only option.
And the first one drops. Roberts has checked in for Houston. And so he makes both from the line. Miami trails by eight. To pack. Here's Wong from down in the low post. It goes.
Yeah, now one of four here in the fourth quarter.
Just under 2.5 minutes gone here in the final quarter. Inside. Here's Roberts. Uses the glass to finish the layup. Roberts got the lead, back up to eight now for Houston.
You can see it. He's taking better shots, and the results are coming because of it.
Here's Peck. It's rebounded by Houston. Walker's got rebound number 11 for him here tonight. The pass to Roberts. A chance there to push it to double digits, but it's off the mark.
I'll tell you, despite his struggles at the offensive end, this team still finds themselves in control of the ballgame.
And Miami making a change here. Walker's checked in. Miller outside, five to shoot. Pass to Peck. The shot, no good. So Houston will take it the other way. Fourth quarter of play, and over 3.5 minutes have gone by. Passes it to Roberts. Shoots over Walker. Tries again, and he could not get that one to go. A lot of contact, and he'll go to the line for two. And he makes the first. That's also good. So he hits both free throws. Miami trails by 10. To Pat. A floater. That one doesn't go. Walker with some nice D.
And they've got a big lead, not just on the scoreboard, but really in the rebounding numbers as well.
Makes it off the glass. And Houston leads by 12.
And it just seems that every pass they make is leading to a score. Just great ball movement.
And Miami shooting a low 30% mark from the field. They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time without a bucket.
Now the pass to Peck. Can they get it? Tries to save it. Walker with the rebound. Walker's got 12 rebounds here tonight. Big time effort. The dish to Roberts. Here's Sasser. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line. And for a lot of up-and-coming teams, getting better defensively is the key to reaching, Greg, that next level. That being considered, what's the first step in that improvement?
A lot of times it's bringing in a great defender, like a Pat Beverly or an Andre Iguodala, a defensive anchor who also inspires his teammates to take that challenge.
The first free throw is good. Joseph, he's checked in for Miami. So he gets them both. Here's Pat. Outside, Joseph. Can they get it? Gets it to go from beyond the arc.
Ooh, finally hitting one from range. That's his first three of the night.
Houston leading by 11. Into the lane. Outside, Walker. And some nice passing there by Houston. Just five to shoot. To the paint. Here's Roberts. Walker with some nice D. Miami trails by 11. Dishes it to Joseph. There's the triple. It's rebounded by Houston.
You've got to find a way to get yourself going in some other way, because hoisting from three is not the answer.
Here's Roberts. Puts the fadeaway right on the money. Roberts got 6 points in the quarter.
Boy, nice shot. He didn't need the fadeaway to create separation, though. He was wide open.
Near the three-point line, it's Joseph. Off the left rim and out.
And if that's the best look you can get on a possession, what a waste of a trip down the floor.
Well, missed opportunities, and they can certainly add up. You cannot afford to take that kind of shot.
Now, here's Walker. Here's Sasser. And it's off from three-point range. Miami trails by 13. Miller dishes to Joseph. There's the three. Can't hit that one. And Houston the other wing.
And there's no doubt about this one. Playing with a lot of confidence tonight. It's a statement victory for Houston.
One area that stands out that we've seen tonight from them, their aggressiveness in getting steals, something I know that you really value yourself.
I think it sparked their offense. It deflates the opposition. And when you have the type of effort we saw tonight, it's pretty hard to overcome that defensive pressure down the stretch.
And so all the hard work here tonight converted into a tally in the win column. It'll be number 26 on the year.
Really, they had their number this season. Two wins, a home win, and an away win.
He can't get it to go. And it's Roberts with the ball. He'll bring it up for Houston. They've only given up 5 points here in the fourth quarter. 1 second separating the shot clock and game clock. Outside, Walker. Just five on the clock. Pass to Roberts. Takes the three. That shot, no good. So we see Houston taking the W here. Even early on in this one, it seemed like they were happy to be playing at home tonight.
And it makes a big difference. Once they started to really play in rhythm, you never felt like they had any doubts as to whether or not they were going to win.
And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. For Greg Anthony, Doris Burke, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for tuning in. Right now, let's take a look at the New Balance Player of the Game.